hi everyone. It's Wednesday. We're still in the Texas Hill Country, and this is just one of many lakes that are around. And actually, this one's on the property that we're having the privilege of staying at, just outside Kerrville. It's just wonderful here. But our show for today isn't for about here. It's about an experience that we had yesterday. And we went to the Alamo, and we want to share that with you. Remember the Alamo? That was the most significant thing that happened, in a sense. And you'll hear why in just a second. We're going to learn about the Alamo. You know, Texas was taken over by Mexico in the early 1800s. It was actually a state in Mexico from 1821 to 1836. But they were just independent. You know, these were settlers that came from, a lot of them, from the east coast of the United States. And they got here and they weren't happy being a part of Mexico. And so there was a rebellion, you could say, and they sought their independence. That led, of course, to the Alamo and people coming from the various states. And we saw the flags of those states earlier in our trip outside of Austin. But down here, well, actually, let me give you the verse for today. And at the end, I'm going to bring that back on how that relates. In Matthew 28:6, it says, "He is risen just as he said." Now, we'll get back to how, obviously that's reference to the people that were looking for Jesus after he had been crucified. They said, "No, he is risen. He is risen." Well, the Alamo, of course, brought in people from all over the country, to fight for the Texas independence. The most famous of those was probably Davy Crockett. And Davy Crockett, as well as Jim Bowie and William Travis, who was the leader of those who were fighting, all died. But Davy Crockett, he had been a congressman. Hey, just for the fun of it, I want you to see this short video on the ballad of Davy Crockett.
Born on a mountaintop in Tennessee, green estate in the land of the free, raised in the woods so's he knew every tree, killed him a bar when he was only three. Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier, fought single-handed through the Indian War, till the Creeks was whipped and peace was in store. And while he was handling this risky chore, made himself a legend forevermore. Davy, Davy Crockett, the man who don't know fear. He went off to Congress and served a spell, fixing up the government and laws as well. Took over Washington, so I heard tell, and passed up the crack in the Liberty Bell. Davy, Davy Crockett, seeing his duty clear. When he come home, his politicking was done. Why, the Western March had just begun. So he packed his gear and his trusty gun, and lit out a grinning to follow the sun. Davy, Davy Crockett, leading the pioneer.
Wasn't that fun? I think it brought back real memories for all of us that were old enough to have viewed the TV show when it was actually a network show. Well, the Alamo, of course, and we'll be showing pictures of all that I filmed. There's not much left standing of it. You'll see some of the pictures of the chapel that is the church that is still standing. Some walls around the courtyard. The courtyard is there. In many ways, it's a museum. Actually, oh, and one other thing that you'll see is a cannon that actually is remaining from the actual defense of the Alamo. And that's amazing that still exists, that anything exists from it. But do you remember what happened? It was not a victory for those seeking independence. Virtually all of them died. 200 men who were fighting that Texas could be free. But they were overrun. It's an interesting story if you want to read how actually Santa Anna was the leader of the Mexican troops. Isn't that interesting? And we, of course, have Santa Anna named after him in our own area. But the Remember the Alamo, that became the battle cry for the fight for independence. And it was a rally. Whenever the battle was, remember the Alamo. And of course, that's kind of why. And they, by the way, they did get their independence. They did get their independence. And so from 1836 to 1846, Texas was its own independent country. But they wanted to belong to the United States, and so in 1847, Texas became a state of the Union. And that is so cool. By the way, one fact that I thought important, I skipped over at the end. Yes, there were 200 men killed, but the Mexican soldiers did spare the women and children and slaves that were there. And so about 15 people did live through and came out on the other side of the Battle of the Alamo. And I thought that was cool. Anyway, they did want to become a state, and they did become a state. The reason I chose the verse that I did for today is that I feel like sometimes maybe we need a battle cry. It rallied the Texas soldiers so much so that they did get eventually their independence from Mexico. I think sometimes we get bogged down with just the battles, and sometimes we lose a battle. But God wins in the end, and we're encouraged in every way to keep the battle going. And maybe we need a battle cry, at least for our own selves. There's no better one than He is risen, just as He said. That's why we keep going in the Christian faith. And sometimes it's hard and sometimes it's not. But we are determined that we will go to that. We will fight to the end. We will run the good fight. Well, not only remember the Alamo, but remember He is risen indeed. Boy, we have another great show for you tomorrow. See you then. Bye-bye.